Hello and welcome back to our Proactive Studios. Here today from Lithium Energy, it's Chairman William Johnson. William, good morning.
Good morning, Alicia.
So William, a maiden lithium resource has been established at your Solaroz project in Argentina. You say this has all the hallmarks of a world-class project.
Absolutely, Alicia, yes. And the maiden resource that we've announced today, 3.3 million tonnes, really does put us in the big league of lithium projects around the world. That size of resource certainly has the potential to support an operation of lithium carbonate production, comparable in size with those of our neighbours in northwest Argentina, being Allkem and Lithium Americas, both of whom have production plants with capacity around about 40,000 tonnes per annum.
This resource also contains a higher grade lithium core, a lithium carbonate equivalent core rather, of 1.34 million tonnes. But you believe this is certainly not the end of the story. Drilling is continuing. Are there opportunities to prove up this resource?
Look, there certainly are. This initial resource is based upon the drilling results from just 5 holes out of our initial 10-hole drilling program, and also just covers an area of less than 5,000 hectares out of our total concession package of 12,000 hectares. So as we advance with drilling, certainly there'll be opportunities to expand and potentially upgrade this resource further.
So as exploration and development continues apace, what do you believe will be the next key milestones in Solaris's journey?
Well, look, we've already started a scoping study on the development of the Solaroz project. And with this maiden resource now defined, we can then advance that study knowing what resource of lithium we have. We've engaged global engineering consultancy Hatch to do that study, which is coming to a conclusion. And we hope to be in a position to announce the results of that study over the next couple of months. The focus of that study was to look at the development of a lithium carbonate production plant using conventional pond evaporation. The capacity of that plant could be anything from 20 to 40,000 tonnes per annum. But we've also been considering the use of newer direct lithium extraction technology, or DLE, that potentially provides some benefits over the pond evaporation. So we've been evaluating those different opportunities, those different options carefully. And one of the, significant pieces of news flow that investors will be looking forward to over the coming months is the conclusion of those studies and our conclusions in terms of which development pathway we propose to go down, whether we pursue the conventional pond evaporation, which we know works on this solar because our neighbours Allkem and Lithium Americas are using that technology. And for Allkem, it's been very successful, and they've been producing lithium carbonate using that approach since about 2015. But like I said, there's alternatives that we want to consider as well.
All right, Lithium Energy Chairman William Johnson, thanks for bringing us up to speed on the maiden resource here and what the next steps are in terms of development.
Thank you, Alicia.